This is Jason Baum with the Virginia Department of Transportation's Office of Communications. I'm here today in our Salem District Office Signal Shop to learn more about the flashing yellow arrow signals that are going to be installed in the Roanoke and Lynchburg areas. Joining me today to talk about these new flashing yellow arrows is Ann Booker, our Assistant Regional Traffic Engineer. So Ann, I understand there are some new types of signals that are going to be coming to the Roanoke and Lynchburg areas. What can you tell me about these new signals?
Well, drivers are familiar with the signal heads that we use for our left turn lanes that include five lights with a steady green arrow and a solid green ball. Now, what we found is that drivers at times misunderstand this green ball and they proceed on without really yielding to the oncoming traffic. We're changing out to a four-light signal head that includes a flashing yellow arrow.
Why is VDOT making this change?
To improve safety. Research has shown that drivers understand the flashing yellow arrow more readily, and they'll yield to that oncoming traffic before making that left turn. About a year and a half ago on 419, we changed out three intersections at Chaparral Drive, Colonial Avenue, and Springwood Park Drive. It had the five light configuration previously, and amongst those three intersections, we had approximately 50 left turn crashes. In the 14 months following the change, we've had only four left turn crashes amongst those three intersections, and we've seen a reduction in the number of crashes and an improvement in safety.
I understand there are 100 signals in the Roanoke and Lynchburg area that will be changed. Where are these 100 signals?
We are changing some more on 419. There'll be some on 220, up to Montgomery County, Appomattox, throughout the forest area of Bedford, really all throughout Roanoke and Lynchburg.
How much is VDOT spending on making this change?
The total cost of the project is about $1.4 million, which sounds like a lot of money. But when you consider that that's less than $14,000 per intersection, and the safety benefit that we anticipate receiving, it's considered a low-cost safety improvement.
How do you think drivers will react and adjust to these new signals?
Well, with everything, there is a learning curve. So I don't anticipate that our drivers will have a hard time with it. Just to make sure, we're also going to install a sign beside the four light head that will say left turn yield on flashing yellow arrow. That sign will be there for about 30 days and then it'll come down.
Does VDOT have plans to install more of these types of signals?
We do. As we reconstruct our intersections when they're needed, we will certainly put up the flashing yellow arrow. In addition, localities in our area have embraced the flashing yellow arrow. It is the national standard and a number of states are using it. So expect drivers to see it more nationwide and certainly in this part of Virginia.
Well, it does sound like a great safety improvement, and I really appreciate you taking the time today to join me here in the signal shop and explain these new flashing yellow arrows to me.
Very welcome.